गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, इन प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव कंप्लीटेड एक्सरसाइज 7.1। इन दैट वी हैव कंप्लीटेड द क्यूब ऑफ द गिवन नंबर एंड देयर प्रॉपर्टीज। इन टुडेज वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन क्यूब रूट ऑफ द नंबर। क्यूब रूट ऑफ द नंबर इज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय दिस सिंबल। देयर वी राइट द 3, देन देयर इज द साइन ऑफ रूट एंड हियर इज द नंबर। ओके, दिस रिप्रेजेंट द व्हाट? क्यूब ऑफ द गिवन नंबर। Here I take example, 7 cube, that is 7 into 7 into 7, answer is 343. 343 is the cube of 7, right? If you have to find out the cube root of this number, 343, then we represent like that, cube root of 343, here we write 3, okay? Is equal to what? Answer is 7, okay? I hope student you understand the representation of cube root. Clear? Here I take some question from exercise 7.2. Here I take question number 1. Question number 1, true and false it is given. Write true, T for the true and F for the false for each of the following statement. I am going to read that statement which is given on page number 130. Okay? There is no cube root of negative integer. Is it true or false? It is false. Okay, we can take the cube root of negative integers also. Clear? Then B statement is given, cube of an odd number is odd. We know the property, cube of odd number is odd. Therefore, its cube root is also what? Odd number. This statement is what? True here. We write T. C statement is given, square of a number is positive. So the cube of that number will also be positive. This is false. Correct? Square of any number is positive only. But cube of negative integer or negative number is negative. Therefore, this statement is false here. D statement is given, for positive integer p, p cube may not be greater than p square. Yes, it is possible. If negative integer is there, their cube is negative and it is smaller than p square, and we know that square of any number is always positive. Okay, therefore this statement is true here. E example is given, or the statement, if a square ends in 9, then a cube ends in 7. A square end with 9, it means there is 3. Okay, if we take their cube, it end with the 7, this statement is what? False there. F, cube root of 27, it is given like that, cube root of 27 plus 64, this is equal to cube root of 27 plus cube root of 64. Okay, now there is plus sign, so you cannot write like that. Okay, if there is multiplication, so you can write separately like that. Okay, therefore according to given statement, this statement is what? Wrong here. Therefore we write false and we mention F there. Okay, for this statement. Now G, the cube of any multiple of 3 is always divisible by 27. It is true statement. We know that cube of 3 is what? 27. If we will take the multiple of that, then you, that number is always divisible by what? 27. This is the true statement. Yet it is given, for a number to be perfect cube, it must have prime factor in pair. It is not necessary. Statement is what? False here. We write F there. I, no perfect cube can end in exactly 2 zeros. This is the true statement. If you take the cube of any number followed by the 0, then that number having the having the 3 zeros, okay, or multiple of the 3, we can say there is no 2 zero. Therefore this statement is what? True here. Then J statement is given, the cube of one digit number, cube of one digit number can be 3 digit number. Okay, if you take the cube of 7, okay, then their cube is what? 343. That is the 3 digit number. It is possible? Yes. Therefore, this statement is also true here. Okay. In this way, you have to complete the question number 1. Question number 2, filling the blanks. This is homework for you. Okay. Now, we see the question number 3. Question number 3 is given. Find the cube root of the following number by prime factorization. Here, we find out the cube root of the given number by prime factorization method. Here I take a example from question number 3. Number is given 2744. Okay. Now to find out the cube root of this number, first we find out the prime factor for the given number. Okay. Now 2744 is the even number. Then it is divisible by 2, first prime number. Okay. After division, we get 1372. Okay. Again, this is the even number. This can be divisible by 2. Okay. After division, here we get the answer 686. Okay. This is the even number. Again, it is divisible by 2. And we get the answer 343. Now, 343 is divisible by the next prime number 3. We use the divisibility property for the 3. Do the addition of this number, 3 plus 4 plus 3, that is 10, and this is not divisible by 3, therefore 343 is not divisible by 3. The next prime number is what? 5. There is no 5, means this number is not divisible by 5. Then check for the 7. Now this number is divisible by 7. After division, we get here 49. Again, 49 is divided by 7, we get 7. 7 is divided by 7, we get 1 here. Okay. Now, prime factors for the given number completed here. We write prime factor for the number 2744 is equal to 2 into 2 into 2, 7 into 7 into 7. These are the prime factor. Now, to find the cube root, what we have to do here? First, we represent that cube root of 2744. Now, these are the factors for 2744. Now, in these factors, we know that if it is perfect cube, their factors, prime factors are in the group of 3. Okay. Now, there is the group of 3, there is the group of 3, that is 7, and this is 2. Out of these 3, you have to take one number, and from this 7, you have to take one number. Okay. And their multiplication represent the what? Cube root of given number. Understood? From the group of this prime number. Okay, this is the group of 2, 2, 2, 2, okay, 3 numbers are given. From this here we take the 2 and from this 3 here we take the 7. Their multiplication, that is 14, is the cube root of 2744. It is very easy. Okay, student, one more example. Here we see example from question number 3rd. Example is given 35,937. This number is given. Okay. Same method. First we find out the prime factor for this number. This number is not divisible by 2. 7, this is the odd number, not divisible by 2, that is the first prime number. Then we see for the next prime number, that is 3. Use the divisibility property first. 5 plus 3, 8. 8 plus 9, that is 17. 17 plus 3, 20. 20 plus 7, 27. 27 is divisible by 3, therefore whole number is divisible by 3. Okay. Therefore, here we divide this number by 3. After division, we get 11,979. We can do division in rough. Okay. Again, this number is divisible by 3. After division, we get 3,993. This number is also divisible by 3. Okay. Then we get 1,331. Now this number is not divisible by 3. Next prime number 5. By 5 also it is not divisible. Next prime number 7. It is not divisible. Then next prime number we check for 11. Then this number is divisible by 11. And we get after division 121. Okay. Now 121 is divided by 11. We get 11. 11 divided by 11 we get 1 here. In this way here we complete the prime factor of this number. Okay. We write the prime factor of 35,937 is equal to 3 into 3 into 3, and then 11 into 11 into 11. Now to find out the cube root of this number, first you represent cube root of 35,937 is equal to. Now out of this 3, here we take 1, okay, and out of this 3 11, here we take 1, that is 11, okay. 3 into 11, their multiplication is equal to what? 33. 33 represent the cube root of this number, or 33 is the cube root of the given number 35,937. This is the required answer. Student, I hope you understand how to find out the cube root of the given number and how to represent the cube root of the numbers. Okay, note down your homework from question number second, that is filling the blanks you have to complete, and question number third, B and D example from this question. Okay, this is homework for you. I hope you understand both the question. This is all for today, student. Thank you for listening me. Thank you very much.